Welcome back, everyone. It's Savage Sasquatch, and we're playing Bloodborne on the PS4. Last time, we defeated the Blood Witches of Hemwick.
Welcome home. What is it, you?
And farmed up a little more. We farmed a little more. Oh, we don't want to go here. I'm sorry, guys. We farmed up more Blood Echoes, and we're going to go and buy the Hunter Chief Emblem. It's the key to the gate at the Grand Cathedral's Round Plaza. I do remember seeing this on our last time through, and brings us right down to 700 Blood Echoes, which is a great place to be at. So I believe that we go to the Cathedral Ward. Yeah. We've grown increasingly powerful since our last time here. We've upgraded our weapons and we've gotten a few more levels. So I'm hoping to see that there's very little to worry about from the regular enemies here. I mean, obviously we can't noob it up, but yeah, this has been kind of nagging at me, and I'm curious, and hopefully we're meant to be here at this point. Occasionally games throw in things that, like, yeah, this was meant for much later. Okay, it's really weird that there's nobody here. And still nobody here. You may remember that I think I entitled the episode Lost and Alone, because this place was so huge that it was difficult to figure out exactly where I was going. Tops, is there anything else up here worth finding? I don't think there is. Glad that I heard him. I'm mainly coming in here just to kill these guys. You get a chunk of experience and like three blood vials. So yeah, that's pretty good. And they're so slow to get up, you can almost just murder the crap out of them before. Yep, that one you can't actually kill him without getting hit. Now they're only worth 800. You know, you lose perspective. It was a lot back then. I remember when this room seemed so scary. Now it's like free stuff. Yay! I think there's only the two paths in and out of here. I might be wrong. That's right, I remember this thing. I hate that thing.
Oh, good to see you safe. Now, let's think up something to discuss. Just tell me what piques your interest.
Okay.
Ah, there's a bit of wisdom from the eminent master Lugarius. Once, a scholar betrayed his fellows at Bergenwald and brought forbidden blood back with him to... It was there that the first of the inhuman vile... The vile bloods are fiendish creatures who threaten the purity of the ruler of the vile blood. And so, to honor for the path to Cain.
K. Cainhurst Castle. I want to hear this one more time.
In his time, Master Ligarius led his executioners into Cainhurst, but all did not go well. And Master Ligarius became tragic. That Master Ligarius should be abandoned in the accursed domain of the Vilebloods. I must free him, so that he may be properly honored in martyrdom.
That gave us different text.
In his time, Master Ligarius, but all the tragic that I must...
Okay.
As you know, the Healing Church, well, I'm a simple hunter, quite unfamiliar, but I have heard that the Holy and that counselors of, if you seek blood, Bergenworth and the Tomb of the Gods, well, once a group of young Bergenworth scholars discovered this led to the founding of the, in this sense, everything, but today, the college, and furthermore, it's unclear, but only the...
Okay.
I bid you farewell.
I bid you farewell, too. I think down here might be the where we have to have the password. Is that?
The password.
Fear the old blood. Okay, we have a new area here. So this is what was talking to us. That's not creepy at all. Already dead. That is freaky. So we went and talked to the guy. So anyway, we finally found something worth... Oh gosh. A new area. And there's two areas here to explore out because we still have that key, or whatever you want to call it, that we just bought. The Forbidden Woods. Curious what kinds of creatures we'll see. Got somebody way down there with a torch. You know, this is a pretty epic entryway into here. I mean, like, you've got everything out, you can see out there, windmills and all this, but it lets you kind of walk down into this area, which is kind of neat. Gotta be really careful that you don't take a wrong turn off a cliff here. Okay, so... So far we're just seeing some of the same enemy types that we've seen before. Nothing real crazy. So the Forbidden Woods, it's very easy, I'm noticing already, to get turned around. Because everything kinda looks the same. Let's pop up here. Oh hey, it's one of our friends. Nope, that's not gonna hit him. Didn't get him. I thought I hit him. Yeah, I saw that he was getting lower, and our hits are pretty strong, so he had to... He basically had to kind of... Let some hits get in to try to attack. Okay. Alright, so it's nice that we've kind of rounded out this area of the Forbidden Woods. Thus far, they haven't been that forbidden, but I'm sure that will change soon. Go down here. Oh, that's a cliff. You know, I love the atmosphere, the fog. I don't love the fog, but as far as creating ambiance, they could do worse. Not much better, though, to be honest. Looks like that's an area we can drop back down from later. I see you, little crow. Not you, the other one. Alright. Locked from the other side? Yeah, it doesn't open from this side. Okay, so we've got here. We've got a lamp to light. On that note, we are going to return to the Hunter's Dream and we're going to level up. We've got the experience for it. And frankly, I still want to find that area where I just don't remember where we used near the Grand Cathedral key or whatever it is that we bought.
Well, what is it?
I desire.
Very well. Let me.
Let's see. Endurance, 2 more points. Strength is 2 more damage. Skill is 1 more damage. Vitality. I think we're decent on health now. I like endurance. The ability to keep swinging is a thing against a lot of these foes.
Well, good hunter.
Wait. Okay, so the Forbidden Woods is part of that area. Alright. So I have my answer here. Unfortunately, we wasted the 10,000 to buy that key. This item right here, the Hunter Chief Emblem, that opens the Grand Cathedral's Round Plaza. Basically, that was the one. That was the key to the door. You can unlock it by going around the back end. In our Lost and Confused episode that we did a couple back, if you go down the stairs from that main cathedral and then you cross the big plaza that has the two big guys walking in circles who are pretty easy to kill, the two giants, and then you cross the small courtyard area to where there's the flame with the flamethrower guy in it, we opened a gate. And that was what that emblem that we just bought for 10,000 does. It opens that, so that way you don't have to go all the way around like that. So let's see what old...
Most of the holy chalices lie deep within the tomb of the gods, and the few that found their way to the surface were lost again in the hands of men. But if the old hunter tales remain true, one of the holy chalices is worshipped in the valley hamlet. Yet the town is in disarray. It was burned and abandoned for fear of the scourge. Home now only to beasts, the perfect place for a hunter. Wouldn't you say?
Okay. Good talk.
One of the
Okay. Oh, there she is. I was like, the doll is been missing. So for all of our exploring, we did farm up enough for one more level. This is where we get 3 more points of stamina, so I'm going to take that. And We have two choices of where we can head next. One of those is that neither of them are there. We can either go into the witch's abode, which is where we killed last episode, where we killed those two Hemwick witches, or we can go into the Forbidden Woods, which we just found by revisiting the cathedral area. We had the password to get in. So I think we are going to go ahead and head into the witch's abode. We're just going to take a brief look around before we end our episode and see what kind of neat things are here. And then we'll be calling it. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. You know, this was a little bit more about exploration and kind of rounding out some areas that are... Let's see, here we go. Rounding out some areas that were unexplored, or, you know, that we were curious what lies this direction or that. Okay, so we go to the witch's abode, and all we find is this. The rune workshop tool. So I'm glad that we remembered that whole password area, because it appears that the password area was... Getting that password was the last thing. So now we are going to venture back to the Hunter's Dream. I know it's a lot of back and forth, but we got another tool for the workshop, it looks like. So we're going to go see what this lets us do, whether it does something for our armor or our weapons. We've still got 3,000 blood echoes, which is great, because nothing usually costs too much here. Okay, or we are going to take a look in our inventory. Let's see here. Rune workshop tool. Kirill runes into one's consciousness. So maybe it doesn't require the workshop. I don't know. Let's see, let's repair weapons while we're thinking of it. So maybe we just go into our Kirill runes. Okay, max vials held up plus one. It doesn't seem that good. You can hold 21 instead of 20. Max bullets up 4. Physical damage reduction by 3%. Temporary boost to transform plus 20. I don't know what that means, but that sounds... I wonder if at some point we're going to be able to transform into a beast. I don't know. Maybe I'm missing some large part of the game here. I don't know. I'm going to take physical damage reduction. I feel like we've never hit a place where carrying a 21st vial was going to do anything special for us. Okay, so that's not how you do that. Knock all your books off the shelves, he's saying.
The healing were once guardians of the hunters. They worked and forged weapons. Today, most minister they have. And so, heed them ascend to.
He's saying ascend to Odin Chapel.
Ascend from.
Wait.
Ascend.
From there, you will find the church workshop. We're going to go take a peek at that before we go any further. I believe it was the Cathedral Ward is where the Odin place was. We never found anybody to send to this guy here. I'm not sure where that plays in. It may yet. We did find two people alive, Alfred and the guy who gives us all kinds of story bits. right before we got to the woods, and neither of them had an option to tell them about the Odon Chapel. Alright. Let's just see what he says.
Ah, oh, this here is a safe place, but if you find any signs of resistance, no?
Nope, nothing special there. Let's just take a brief look around. I don't see a workshop. Perhaps that's something we'll figure out in a later episode, but for now, we're going to go ahead and call it from here. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Enjoy having you along. And give us a thumbs up to show your support. Leave us a friendly message or let us know how you like things so far. And by all means, please hit the subscribe button above or find the link below in the description. And we'll be picking up next time in the Forbidden Woods. But until then, this is Savage Sasquatch, and I am out of here.